Welcome to Lakefront Tackle. Today we're going to be making some traditional cork floats, and I'll show you how I do it. A lot of people use a horizontal lathe, but I like to use the drill press. Doesn't need any special tools or anything. So first we start out by drilling through the cork. And I'm going to be doing this a couple of different ways. One with just a traditional wine cork, and then some bottle stoppers that are glued together to make a little bit bigger float. So we just drill a hole through the cork, and we put in a piece of either bamboo or reed. After I've glued the cork to the stick, I simply set it up in the drill press and then go through a couple of different sandpapers to shape the cork. This one's just the regular wine bottle cork. I think that's about a 50 grit or 30 grit to do the rough shaping. And then I'll go back with a 100 grit and then a 220 grit and get it nice and smooth. So that's pretty much the rough shaping there, and then just smooth it down with some finer grits. And that's about all there is to it. Next, I'm going to do it with the bottle stoppers that are glued together. And again, it just starts with drilling a hole through it. I tried to cheat here too and use some instant glue, which doesn't work very well. It's better to use like a tight bond or a waterproof woodworking glue. And once again, it's going to be just the same simple process of going through various grits of sandpaper to shape it and then smooth it. You can see a little bit of wobble because the hole is not perfectly centered, but that doesn't really matter because as you turn it with the sandpaper, it'll balance it out. And now I'll flip it over and finish off the other end. It's a little awkward because I'm trying not to block the camera, but normally I just put it behind it and use the sandpaper from behind to shape it. But you get the idea. It's really worth it to take the extra time to make the cork really smooth, and it'll make the finished product look a lot better. And there it is. Okay, now the next thing is the fun part, and this is a cool tool that I made from scratch to do it when you wrap it with the thread. So basically, I just took some birch and built this little jig holder with a handheld drill that I got off of eBay. And that way, you can hold your bobber and use the handheld drill to slowly wind it and put the thread on. And it really works pretty good. Part that supports the part that's coming out of the drill slides back and forth so you can easily adjust it. Okay, so now we're going to paint the bobber, and that is made a lot easier using this tool. So this is just a thick acrylic paint. Sometimes you might want to do a couple of coats. Depending on how the paint covers. I might try to make some sort of a little hand rest too. So we'll set that one aside to dry and take up another one and do some threading. So I've taken a safety pin and I've cut off the clasp part and I'm putting it over the end of this stick to use as a hook. and then I simply start winding the thread where the safety pin piece connects with the wood, and I use a little super glue to hold it on to begin with. Later, when the finish is on, the whole thing will be pretty rock solid. I use a little clamp to hold the thread tight. And you want to keep the pressure on the thread as you wind it. What gives the bobbers those distinct patterns. Some people tie them off and pull the thread back through the windings, which you can do, but I find once the finish is all done, it's really unnecessary, and a little super glue holds the thread very well. To start it in the cork, take the X-Acto knife and put a little slot in the cork that'll hold the thread tight, and then you can begin winding off of that. You can hold it in with a little bit of super glue. So you kind of just squeeze the thread down into the slot you've cut, a little bit of super glue, trim it off, and you're ready to wind. And at this stage, if your winding's a little off, you can always back it off and wind it up again. Keep a little pressure on the thread. And seal it down with a little super glue. So you can cut a little slot in the wood and use that to initially hold the thread. Put a little super glue in there. Put the thread into that little slot. And it should set up pretty quick. You can use your nail or you can use the back of the X-Acto blade to squeeze the windings together a little bit. And I think I was just nervous because I was filming this one. Just straighten up the windings, and that's about it. And now, it's on to the finish. I like to dip and dry about four times into a polyurethane spar varnish. And then once that's all completely dry, I'll dip the tip in either white or black or white and black paint to make a little decorative pattern at the very top. Now, unfortunately, I filmed this with one hand with my iPhone, so the aspect ratio is off. But you can see it's just a mason jar with a very heavy spar varnish. And with two hands, it's a little easier. And I just put in a little wire hook and dip the other side and then hang them up to dry, usually overnight. And repeat it again three more times. Let that dry out and then dip the tip for a paint. And I got the little wire tip on it. And hang it up with feathers. I got a piece of cardboard down to catch all the drips. And that's all there is to it.